Agentic AI may be hurting large public cloud providers. How can that be? Let's talk about it. So welcome back to AI Insights Innovation, the one place where you can understand the true application of AI technology for the enterprise. I'm your host, David Linthicum, internationally known AI expert and analyst with theCUBE Research. Let's get to work. So firstly, let's recap what Agentic AI is. Agentic AI systems are autonomous, goal-driven systems that are capable of making independent decisions and optimizing their processes with minimal external input or oversight. These systems don't rely on brute-forced computations like traditional AI systems. Instead, they exhibit resource efficiency in both processing and storage. So really kind of the core issue is that the processors and the resources that public cloud providers provide may not be needed for agentic-based systems. And so ultimately, we're looking at this as an opportunity to downsize the use of AI, where everybody was moving to, you know, massive GPU systems and massive storage systems, in things that are going to be a bit more elegant in their design, but, you know, use fewer resources and also use resources that are going to cost less. And so agentic AI seems to be that kind of architecture. And so that's not good news for the public cloud providers, because that's the business they're in. They make money on selling resources, massive processors, massive platforms, and massive storage systems. So enterprises are rethinking where the agentic AI systems should reside. So therefore, agentic AI's architecture inherently deviates from the resource-intensive workflows that public cloud providers are built to support. And as this technology grows, it could reduce the demand for public cloud providers, including compute, storage, and scalable infrastructure. So this doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be a foregone conclusion, but I just see the adoption of agentic AI systems in enterprises that are leveraging this technology as not needing those high-end resources that the cloud providers provide. So some of the key characteristics of agentic AI and how it uses resource, it has autonomy and localized processing. So agentic AI operates independently, often requiring lightweight, specialized computational power localized to the system or device itself. It eliminates the need for frequent offloading of workloads to cloud-based systems. So if we're going to run this thing on our phone, you know, such as Apple Intelligence and other smaller platforms, it doesn't necessarily need the brute force of the cloud providers out there that do a good job in providing very high-end resources to deal with scalable and very computationally and storage-intensive systems. But that comes at a price. Cloud providers don't give that away for free. And so as everybody's finding out these days, that if you use a lot of those resources, you're going to get a large cloud bill. So if there's an opportunity to use an architecture such as an agentic that's going to get us to a more better value state and bring more value back to the business, I think enterprises are going to take advantage of that. So first and foremost is a smaller data footprint. Agentic AI's decision-making and learning happen with streamlined and focused data sets, significantly reducing the demand for large-scale cloud storage. These models are able to continue to evolve internally, avoiding the traditional need for mass data transfer and external training updates. So they don't move a lot of data. They don't use a lot of data. They may have data that's accessing that are external to the agents that they may get to from time to time. They may have some databases or data sets that are going to be internal to the agent, but these are not very data intensive systems. You got to remember that the agentic AI systems that we're seeing built these days are going to be purpose built for a particular business process. It's going to be inventory control, logistics management systems, things like that, where a multitude of agents are operating in a distributed fashion that are brought together to achieve common goals and objectives. And so in other words, within a multi-agent environment, it's akin to a very complex distributed system where you have all of these agents that are running on various platforms where they can do the most good. But as far as data storage goes, they don't deal with a lot of data typically. Now that's obviously, there's going to be exceptions to the rule, but if you look at what agentic's good at, massive amounts of data storage is typically not on the agenda for agentic-based deployments. So also adaptability and edge compatibility is a factor as well. So agentic systems are designed to function and to operate efficiently in low power or edge environments where the cloud Access may be intermediate. So minimize reliance on elastic, scalable cloud infrastructures. And ultimately, you know, these allow these things to operate in a disconnected fashion. AI systems typically are dependent on reaching out to back-end knowledge models. And if you're dealing with a RAG-based system, reaching out to databases and even the actual web as well, agents don't necessarily need that. They're able to operate in a disconnected fashion. And so in other words, we can have an agentic AI system where some agents are operating on an airplane where connectivity, you know, may be sparse, and you have agents that are operating by themselves until they reestablish connectivity when, say, an airplane gets on the ground and gets closer to a cellular network or a Wi-Fi network. Well, agents are kind of set up to do that. They're not necessarily dependent on back-end systems like a lot of applications are. You know, take your phone, for example. You know, chances are if you're running an application on your phone, it has some sort of a back-end system that it needs to carry out its operations. Agents normally don't have that same dependency. So they don't have to reach out to the mothership each and every time as they're operating. They can operate disconnected of clouds and also disconnected of each other. They're able to function independently for a certain amount of time, and that provides a great deal of power to the architecture. So I'm asserting there is a shrinking role of public cloud providers in the agentic space. Reduced dependency on cloud computing is going to be an outcome of this. Agentic AI systems by design do not require the high-performance GPUs or TPUs. TPU instances often billed at a premium by the cloud providers out there, as we established earlier. So the industry is shifting to agentic-based systems as an option for building their AI systems. And I think that demand for compute-intensive cloud resources will fall based on that. And so cloud, as we talked about before, really set up for very high-end, highly scalable systems. And certainly they can run large-scale AI systems, such as AI systems use massive amounts of GPUs. But they're normally not the best cost-effective way to do that. So while people are looking for alternatives for their traditional generative AI systems, if you can say traditional, ultimately, the agentic-based systems are going to get us more into the niche of leveraging lower-end, lower-cost platforms that typically are not going to be in a cloud provider. And so we're able to leverage some of the on-premises systems. We're able to leverage, you know, some of the IoT-based systems where the agents are going to run on devices and thermostats and in our cars, things like that, where the cloud providers aren't necessarily going to play a major role there. They're going to be there, by the way. We're going to have systems and assets that exist in the cloud. But as far as where the processing and the data storage is going to occur, it's probably not going to be as focused on the public cloud as we thought a few years ago. So also declining demand for cloud storage. Instead of storing and processing terabytes or petabytes of data on cloud platforms, agentic uses only the necessary subsets of data to act autonomously. Storage elasticity, you know, once a selling point for cloud providers, is really kind of less relevant in the world of agentic AI workflows. Again, storage isn't front and center with these sorts of architectures. Now, you may have a particular business need where storage has to play a more primary role in an agentic system, not discounting that, but for the majority of agentic-based systems that are being developed out there, and also if you look at the purpose or the theme of the architecture, massive amounts of storage normally are not going to be a part of that. And so the cloud loses out. They make most of their money on selling cloud-based storage. And if that's not necessarily going to be something that's on the shopping list of enterprises out there, they're going to move to more value-oriented platforms. They're going to move to managed service providers. Then many instances are going to buy their own hardware, and sometimes the agentic systems are going to be deployed on devices, and so the platforms are going to be mobile computing systems. It's going to be factory robots, you know, anything that supports a small operating system and a storage device. Raspberry Pis, for example, and other devices out there that are very low-end, low-powered systems that don't cost a lot are going to be a primary platform for AI agents and agentic AI. So the theme of agentic is going to be a smaller footprint and more control. Architectures for agentic AI favor smaller systems, custom hardware, low-powered processors specialized for autonomous systems. And enterprises are able to manage this infrastructure in very creative platforms where they're able to deal with value-oriented operating systems and hardware. They're going to be able to cut out many of the cloud expenses that we're seeing today. The enterprises are spending a tremendous amount of money on cloud resources, probably more than we thought a few years ago. As I write about in my book, An Insider's Guide to Cloud Computing, typically enterprises, for what they thought they were going to be spending in, say, 2010 to 2013 and 2020 to 2025, they would describe their cloud expenses as being about 2.5 times what they thought they were going to be, you know, 10 years ago. And that's consistent across the enterprises right now. And so they're asking the question, why do we need to be spending all this money? Are there alternatives we're able to find? Leveraging our own hardware, finding alternative architectures. And now that AI is coming along, I think people are asking the question, we don't need these big brute force platforms to run these AI systems. And leveraging architectures like Agentic AI leads itself to that. Our small language models, there are other alternatives where we're not necessarily trying to deploy a large language model within the enterprise, which is something that enterprises shouldn't do. So again, the application for AI as we see it are going to be very business-focused, tactical applications we can build in a short period of time, you know, typically 3 to 6 months, and cost less than a couple of million bucks. So the idea that we're going to build, you know, a ChatGPT or a DeepSeek for the enterprise is just not based in reality. So if most of the AI deployments and applications built out there are going to be tactically focused, then architectures like Agentic play right into that need. And if you look at what Agentic is, it's kind of in terms of an architecture and enabling technology, it's custom built for those sorts of tactical uses of AI. So Agentic AI is also able to improve regulatory and security outcomes. By limiting the need to shuttle data to and from public clouds, Agentic AI simplifies compliance. So we have to deal with compliance and regulations like GDPR, HIPAA, CCPA. Critical industries gain enhanced control over their data assets, especially in sectors like healthcare, defense, and financial services. So at the end of the day, we can see the devices where these agents are running, typically if they're not in the cloud. And so that provides a greater degree of control because we can put physical security assets around them. So you're not going to have devices, you know, devices that are under your physical control. You don't know where it's running within the cloud. I don't really think that's a problem per se. I've never heard of, you know, people having data stolen physically. But many of the industries right now are doing on-premises audits and, you know, having something that's highly regulated that's running on a device that you own or running on a computer server that you own or running on a computer server you can go and see, that's usually the case. It's in a rented colocation provider or a managed service provider, is going to provide you with a better security profile. So what are some of the counterarguments that the public cloud providers were able to respond? Well, Agentic AI and its shift toward edge-oriented services, you know, like AWS, IoT, Greengrass, Azure, Percept, that cater to localized AI processes may be an option for agentic-based systems, and the cloud providers would argue that. So cloud vendors are investing in hybrid solutions to support on-prem deployments, ensuring they remain relevant, even if the workloads shrink and scale. So I think, you know, cloud providers, by the way, all friends of mine, all smart, they see this coming. They understand their infrastructure is not necessarily set up to address agentic or provide the best value drivers for agentic. And so they're shifting their infrastructure to support it. And we're seeing more tactical use cases, small language models, things like that. I think they realize that every enterprise out there is not going to build these giant honking AI systems that cost $1 million a month to run. They're going to be more tactical deployments where many of these are going to be agentic, small language models, things like that. So this is all about the role of scaling distributed agentic systems. While agentic AI is able to minimize the need per individual system in terms of resources consumed, scaling multiple agents across a global enterprise may still need orchestration via cloud services, according to the cloud providers, and they may have a point. Public cloud providers could focus on optimizing frameworks for interoperability of agentic AI systems. I think the big thing is that the public cloud providers don't focus on leveraging platforms outside of their own ecosystem, even multi-cloud platforms. You rarely hear organizations that are talking about systemic support for these things. And that's a bit scary for people who understand that their world is going to be very complex and heterogeneous. And if you're dealing with agentic systems, you're not going to run all the agents on a single environment. It doesn't really kind of make sense to do it that way. But you're going to run them in a distributed fashion where they're the closest to the processes or the workloads or the applications where they can do the most good. And I think we're going to see those sorts of architectures, which kind of rule the day probably over the next 5 years as AI becomes more of a reality for the enterprises. Also, we figure out new ways to run older applications that are going to bring more value back to the business. So what does this mean for the future? Well, the cloud economy is shifting to fit smaller players. As agentic AI systems replace traditional cloud-heavy workflows, the revenue models of cloud providers may shrink or transform. I think it's going to be shrinking before they shift and pivot and move over to support agentic and other AI smaller workloads in a better way than they're doing right now. So the providers, I think, are actually going to change their offerings to support this kind of niche of services like edge computing solutions and hyper-specialized AI hosting environments such as Agentic. However, those guys can't turn on a dime. It's going to take them a few years to, you know, figure out new ways to alter their infrastructure to support these types of workloads. I don't think they're set up to do that now. They're set up to support highly scalable monolithic kinds of systems with large amounts of data and large amounts of processing, where enterprises are going to find value in having an eclectic array of things that they can provision on demand. Agentic doesn't necessarily need that. It's not a bad thing, and certainly applications are going to use cloud and continue to use cloud. Cloud's still going to see a big growth. However, I do think the growth is going to occur primarily with private cloud providers, specialized cloud providers, people like CoreWeave, that are providing AI clouds, managed service providers, co-location providers, and also hardware providers such as, you know, Dell and HPE, providing platforms for agentic-based deployments. That just seems like it's going to be the likely future. So businesses are going to prioritize self-sufficient autonomous systems with minimal third-party dependencies. That's where the future is moving to. So agentic AI rising can catalyze a broader trend towards smaller hardware ecosystems and custom-built infrastructure solutions. And typically, those are not necessarily going to include public cloud, at least in the short term. Again, the cloud providers may pivot to figure out their niche in that area. They're still going to be relevant for some of these larger systems. But as far as agentic deployments go, if enterprises move over in that direction as a preferred architecture for AI deployments, the cloud provider is going to miss out, at least in the short term. So what does this all mean? Well, agentic AI's architecture disrupts public cloud's value by reducing the reliance on compute-intensive and data-heavy resources. So as the technology matures, we may witness a paradigm shift where businesses reclaim control over their AI workloads, adopting on-prem or edge solutions as the new standard, leveraging agentic AI as the preferred architecture and small language models as the preferred architecture to make that happen. So what does this all mean for businesses? Start considering the efficiency advantages of agentic AI and its potential to reduce cloud dependencies. For cloud providers, anticipate this shift and adapt by expanding offerings to support the self-sufficient AI systems of the future, meaning agentic-based systems. That doesn't mean agentic AI can't run on cloud providers. It's just probably not a very value-oriented way to do that right now. And I think that people need to understand that ultimately, within the world of IT, businesses are going to gravitate toward where the value drivers are. In other words, the technology and the architectures are able to leverage, that's going to focus on returning the most value back to the business, not necessarily what's trendy. And for that, cloud computing, I think, is going to find they're at a bit of a loss. Well, that's all for this week. Don't forget to like, subscribe. Also, check out our other assets at theCUBE Research. Also, check out the other videos here from my colleagues at theCUBE. There's some great content here. Also, you know, check out the other assets at SiliconANGLE in terms of the columns and the articles that are there. Huge amounts of resources that are there for at your disposal that you can leverage. So until next time, everybody be very safe. I'll see you soon. Bye.